Hello folks, here is a quick guide on how to utilize Shenhe's unique kit and maximize her effectiveness. Her main role is to buff your cryo main DPS and provide decent damage with her own burst. Let's not waste any more time and dive right in. Both of Shenhe's abilities are great to level. Don't worry too much about her normal attacks. Her elemental skill gives every character on your team some icy quills, which increases the cryo damage for a certain number of hits. In addition, her Ascension 4 passive increases your team's damage even more, depending on if you hold or press a skill. Here's a comparison of the bonus damage you get from her icy quills with Ganyu's burst. The bottom left is her unbuffed damage, the top left is with icy quills, and the top right is with icy quills and Shenhe's Ascension passive for another 15% damage increase. The more attack you stack on Shenhe, the higher the damage bonus from her icy quills. Her elemental burst does cryo damage over 12 seconds, but it also shreds the cryo and physical resistance of enemies inside her burst circle. The size is pretty big, almost the size of Zhongli's burst. And Shenhe's Ascension 2 passive makes her burst give another 15% cryo bonus damage to those inside the circle, similar to Ganyu's passive. So there are two ways to build Shenhe. One way, which is my preferred style, is to maximize her buffing abilities by boosting her attack and energy recharge. For this build, you want ER or attack percent sands and attack percent on both the goblet and helmet. Try to get ER substats if you can, since her burst costs 80 energy. For artifacts, go with 2-piece gladiator and 2-piece shimanawas for the extra attack bonus, or 4-piece noblesse to provide your team with another attack buff. For weapons, go with the one that boosts the most attack or energy recharge, with higher priority for 5-star polearms. However, since Shenhe is not doing the bulk of your damage, Lithic Spear, Blackcliff Poe, and Favonius Lance are all decent picks here. The other build is to balance her damage and buffs. This build is best on freeze teams, since Shenhe can benefit from all the crit bonuses from your cryo team synergies. With this team, try to get 4-piece Blizzard Strayer for the extra crit buffs, but you can settle for a hybrid mix of the 18% attack sets as well. The artifact main stat will be a little bit more normal this time around. You want attack percent sands, cryo or attack percent goblet, and a crit or attack helmet. The stats are a lot more flexible this time around. For substats, you still want energy recharge and attack over crits. Weapon priority is still pretty much the same as the first build though. All the 5-star weapons will be better than 4-stars since they have higher base attack. Then prioritize the ones that boost attack or energy recharge. Shenhe's best team will be a freeze team, but she can still shine as long as you have a cryo main DPS on the roster. Ganyu, Ayaka, Yula, Rosaria, and Kaya can fill that main DPS role. For the last two slots, add a healer and another support that can synergize with your cryo DPS. And here is the combo route for most teams. You want to start with Shenhe's E, then Q. Next, use your cryo DPS's E and Q, followed by your support's E and Q. Once you run through the four bursts, swap back to Shenhe and hold her elemental skill, before finally switching back to your main carry's normal and charge attack. This will refresh the icy quills and buff your carry's normal and charge attack damage thanks to Shenhe's Ascension passive. So here's a quick roundup. If you have a cryo main DPS you like to use, then Shenhe can boost their damage by a good amount. It's also easier to give her artifacts since she isn't competing for the crits like most other characters. However, if you do not have a cryo main DPS, then Shenhe might not be worth pulling for your account. But if you don't care about min-maxing, then pull with your hearts. She still looks beautiful regardless of how her kit works. Anyways, that's it for my quick guide. Thanks for watching, and as always, have fun out there, traveler. Obey.
Finally, I to the fairy.
Unleash! Do your master's bidding. This is long overdue. No touching. Shadows of fate. Transfiguration.
Cheap tricks.